everyone, welcome back to my channel Mingby. My name is Mandy and I am a full-time reseller, and today I am going to show you a 30 pound ThredUp box. I did purchase this one on, what was it, St. Patrick's Day, I think, for 30% off. This one did not come from Arizona, thankfully. I've had my fair share of Arizona boxes now. It did come from Pennsylvania. I don't have all the information, like the numbers, in front of me. I will put it here. I'm pretty sure I had credit to cover the box with the 30% off. So right on top, I am seeing some older looking jeans. I don't know if that's going to be good or not. We shall see. So first up is a pair of Lee Slim Fit Skinny Leg Mid-Rise. And I'm not seeing a size on these, so I don't know. I probably won't bother measuring them. They look kind of worn here in the knees. So these will probably just get put in a rummage sale. These do not feel good at all. No boundaries. These are just going to get donated. They're just really puckered here in the front. If you don't know what that is, this is a great example. It's where the elastic just breaks apart. You mainly see this on skinny jeans. And it's either from somebody wearing them and they might be just a little too tight, or it can happen after time from being washed in a hot dryer. So, I mean, these are just trash. Express jeans, legging, size 6. Like a dark wash. These might have been cut. I know some jeans obviously are raw hem, but if you look at, especially this side here, that's not very even. So I'm assuming these were cut. I'll probably put them in the rummage sale. I'm hoping for some decent stuff because I really don't have a lot of jeans right now in my eBay store or my Poshmark closet. This is Good American. This brand has really kind of fallen for me. It's like, I am dropping prices and people still really are not interested. This is a size 16 in like a acid wash. I'm assuming this is not supposed to be this way, unfortunately, where this knee is overly ripped. Some jeans are like that, but with the fraying down here, I don't think they are. I'll look up a stock photo, but yeah. I'll have to look into these. These don't feel good. Cut from the cloth. I have been doing good with this brand, but these are skinny. They're very, very thin. They've just really been worn. So these I will probably just donate. I have a feeling there's a lot of skinny jeans in here. Carly Jean Los Angeles. Don't know it. It seems like a cheapy brand. I think the hems are supposed to be like that. What is that, like a step hem, I think that's called, or something? These don't feel good, so these are just gonna get, well, I'll maybe do the rummage sale on these. Wit and Wisdom. I've said this many times, I'm not a huge fan of this brand, but I might have to list these just because so far not much has been happening in this box. They are a good size. Their stretch, unfortunately the style code tag has been removed, but to me these look like a black skinny jean, so I will probably list those for not very much. Just USA. I don't know, it seems like a boutique brand to me. These are very stretchy. Seem to be a skinny jean. I'll look into these. I have been selling quite a bit of skinny jeans, but they have been like good brands, not just, you know, brands that people really aren't searching for. celebrity pink. That's nothing I want to bother with. These are skinny, tiny size, high rise ankle. These can go in the rummage sale. AG Contour 360, the Farrah Skinny Button Up. These look like they're pretty tiny. Size 26. They are a button fly. For whatever reason, button fly and skinny jeans seem to do better. I think, you know, people want to wear them with like little crop tops in the summer. So I will probably list these. Is there a pair of Ann Taylor jeans? The only reason I know that is looking at this button that says Ann Taylor. They're the Modern Fit, size 2 petite, so also very small. I might try listing them, but probably will not get very much. So far this box is kind of reminding me of the last ThredUp box I did, the women's 25 piece, where I would say 90% of it was a size like, what, small and lower. There was not very much variance in the sizing. Lucky Brand Charlie Baby Boot in a size 0, so more small. Lucky Brand's kind of hit or miss for me. It really depends on the style. I'm also noticing that I'm getting a lot of like this darker indigo kind of wash right now. I think the lighter washes are more popular, but there are still people that do like dark wash. Here's a pair of True Religion jeans. These are a skinny. I've never done like really great with this brand. I don't know if it's I pick up the wrong kinds or what. This is a bigger size though, a size 36. They are black. I don't see any puckering or anything. It does have the traditional True Religion pockets. So I'll list these. These might be good. If I haven't mentioned, I will put comps somewhere on the screen for some of the items. I'm not going to do everything. Here's another pair of True Religion jeans. These are the Julie. They're size 26. These look to be a little bit older. Black. I'm assuming the Julie is like a slim straight. Or just a straight maybe. I will probably list these, not for much. These do need to be washed. There's definitely something here on the back. These are Can-Can jeans. I'll have to look up the style with the style code in here. They are a size 26. I don't get much for Can-Can, but I do feel like there is a following and people know what they're looking for in this brand. Probably around like 16 to 20 for these jeans. This is a good style. Quite a bit of distressing on them, which I think is kind of going out, but there are still people that do like that. Okay, now I'm seeing a little bit more lighter wash, so we'll see. Kenzie jeans, I don't think that this is anything special, size 31. I don't know. I don't think these are skinny. Since these are a lighter wash, I might try them. I was going to say Play-Dohs, but these might be a skinny. I'll have to look into these. These are a pair of BDG Girlfriend High Rise in a size 28. I just really don't have the best luck with this brand. I don't know why. So I will probably list them. If they don't sell within a while, I know Play-Dohs will definitely take these. Here's another pair of Just USA. So like I said, I need to look into these. They're very stretchy, size 30. These look to be like a wide leg. I don't believe they were hemmed, but it does. No, I don't think they were hemmed. So So I'll have to look into this brand. It could be like a Judy Blue type thing. So we'll see about those. These are trash. You can see right here, there's already a hole. So these are just going to go in the garbage. Dollhouse roll up skinny capri in a size 9. Yeah, not really into this. Somebody might pick these up at the Roman sale for like a dollar. I don't know this brand, khaki and blue, khaki plus blue, just khaki blue. I'm not sure what that says. These are pretty stylish though. In the back, they have these little smiley faces. I'll look this up if it's nothing special. It does need to get washed. I think Play-Dohs will definitely take those. Woman Within, size 14W. These are just going to go to Goodwill. They do not feel good at all. And yeah. Talbot's Straight Crop, size 16. Don't know that I've ever sold jeans from Talbot's. Maybe. If I have, I don't think that they move very fast or for a lot of money because I don't remember it, but these seem to be in decent condition. There is a little spot here, so I'll probably throw them in the wash. Crop jeans are good for summer. We're nearing the end of the box. Denim Co. Is that like and denim, or is that different? I'm not really sure. This is kind of like a grungier wash. I might just send these to Play-Dohs. I don't know that I need to try listing them. So far, no men's jeans, which is kind of surprising to me. Normally, there's at least like 2 or 3. These are a pair of Caslon. These don't feel good. They feel old. They feel kind of grimy. So I'm just going to get rid of those. Old Navy, extra high rise, sky high straight, size 0. I don't normally mess with anything under like a large in Old Navy, so these I will send to Play-Dohs. I'm pretty sure they will take them. Just have to see if they need to be washed. Time and True, just a pair of like coral pants. I'll throw those in the rummage sale. I will try selling Time and True if they are over like a 16 for their jeans and they're in a, you know, more current style because people are looking for those. Knox Rose, this is their newer label, size 14. These look to be like a pull-on flare with this nice lighter wash. So I will sell these myself. And the last pair, Silver Jeans Co., and these are a size, let me probably cut the tag out. Size 32. I will probably give these a try myself just because they are a bigger size. They have a lot of stretch to them. Okay, so that was the last box. I am going to count up what I have and let you know kind of the numbers and what we're looking at for average cost of goods. So I have all of my numbers now. I looked it up and the total was $34.17. That was with shipping and tax and then taking off the discounts, but my credit did cover the whole box. So essentially it's free, but I'm saying $34.17. I am keeping 13 pairs to sell myself. ThredUp, I'm going to send 4 of these right back to ThredUp in a box. The garage sale is getting 4. I'm sending 3 to Play-Dohs, and then I'm either donating or just completely throwing away 5 pairs. So that leaves me with an average cost of goods of $263, which isn't horrible. I don't know, this box was okay. Kind of a mixture of what I'm keeping, like the Good American, those are little bit bigger in size. The AG jeans might be okay. What else did we have in here? Those silver jean shorts should do well. The True Religion, I'll have to look into those. I'm not concerned that I won't make my money back. I'm guessing probably average from what I have here. I will probably have them listed, I don't know, like 15 to 23 is my assumption, just based on the prior knowledge that I have. Something could go maybe for a little bit more, but I will find that out once I start listing them. I haven't watched too many ThredUp videos recently, but the last batch that I did watch, almost everyone got them from Arizona. So I don't know what's going on at ThredUp. Like I said, this box was okay. It definitely wasn't trash or anything like that, but it does seem like quality is not as good as it once was, or maybe I'm just not getting, you know, the lucky boxes. I don't want to say I'm never going to get ThredUp boxes again, because that, you know me, that's not true, but I might start focusing more on Quick Lots boxes that seems to have better brands, better quality compared to ThredUp, and looking into some other vendors online to just kind of switch it up and see if I can get better items for my money. And then the money that I am making from ThredUp, I normally was just keeping it in my account there and then using it for the boxes. So I might just start pulling that out, you know, and just get the cash for the things that I'm sending in. And as always, if you enjoyed today's video, please make sure to give it a like. It really helps out the channel and I really appreciate it. I will see you on the next one. Bye!